Hello! Welcome back to my channel. I am Andrea Perry. I'm so happy you are here. In this video, I'll be going over what qualifications you need to work for VIPKid. So what is VIPKid? You actually teach students in China. The students can range anywhere from 3 years old to 18 years old. VIPKid is located in Beijing, China. There is also an office in San Francisco. Contracts are 6 months long. VIPKid does not have any minimum or maximum classes that you have to teach per week. You can make your own schedule and you don't have to request any time off. You just don't open slots for the days that you want to take off. So for VIPKid, you need a laptop or a desktop, and you have to download their app to teach through their platform. For the laptop specifications, you have to have a Windows 7 or above, and your Mac has to be a 10.1 or greater. Your computer has to have at least an i5 processor to support the platform. You also should have at least 8 gigabytes of RAM on your computer. You also want to have a high-speed internet connection of 25 megabytes or greater. Another thing you want to have for VIPKid is some kind of a backup. Just in case something happens where you can't enter the classroom in your normal laptop or your desktop, you just want to make sure you have some kind of backup. You are unable to teach on your phone, so I recommend having a second laptop, or if you're using a desktop, to have a laptop, or you can use an iPad. Now, the iPad does not support all of the levels, so you just want to be careful and watch as you're progressing through the levels which ones you can teach on an iPad and which ones you can't. So for VIPKid, you need a bachelor's degree in any subject. It's okay if it's accounting, if it's a general studies degree, as long as it's a bachelor's, you will qualify. You also need 2 years working with children. It can be babysitting, it can be having your own children, it could be teaching in a brick and mortar classroom, it could be tutoring, it can be counseling, anything related with children, just at least 2 years experience. You also have to live in the United States or Canada. Currently, California is the only one that they are not taking applications for. You also need a headset with a microphone. I will link in the description the one that I currently use. It was about $20. You also need some kind of webcam, either built into your desktop or your laptop, or you can have an external webcam for better quality video and also better brightness too while you're in the classroom. Some internal cameras I find are a little grainy, or they don't have the best picture quality. You also want to have some kind of ring light, or you want to have a well-lit classroom so the student can see you. This particular ring light was only about $10. This is what I started with, and I did not have an external webcam. I actually started with an internal one. You also want to have some kind of educational background. It does not have to be anything extravagant like this. I actually just started with a map that I got from the Dollar Tree, and I just kind of grabbed a bunch of different things from the Dollar Tree and maybe spent $5 to $10, if that, just on certain things that I thought I might have needed in the classroom. Another thing you should have is an orange shirt. Obviously, I got this made, but to find an orange shirt, I actually went to Walmart and just scoured, and apparently if you go around September, October, there are absolutely no orange shirts but pumpkins. So I actually found a shirt, I don't even know where I found it at, but it was not even the right color orange, it was some really burnt, ugly orange. But I wore that for my mock class to try to show them that I was serious about the job, and orange is one of their colors. However, you do not have to wear orange in the classroom. You can wear anything that has VIPKid on it. I actually wear a hoodie every day that says VIPKid teacher with some apples on the bottom, and I'll link that in the description box. It was maybe like $20, $25, but I waited until I had a couple paychecks from VIPKid before I bought that. My main go-to Dollar Tree items that I bought, I actually got a reward system, like stars, because for VIPKid you give stars throughout the classroom, and I just thought it'd be super cute to just hold this up to them. I also got trophies. When I first started, I kind of just gave trophies, and I still give trophies in my classroom today, and the students don't mind, even for the kids who have had me for more than 50 classes. I also use this a ton. I think this is the most awesome prop because you can use it for, obviously, ball, you can use it for world, you can use it for throw, you can use it for catch. I just love this prop, it's so easy, and it only cost me $1. Another thing that I found very helpful are puppets. Sometimes students have a hard time speaking to strangers. It's scary for them to learn a new language, especially if you have younger children. So this gets them to interact with you, and sometimes you could just talk to a puppet, which is super cool, right? You also want to have some kind of whiteboard. I literally got this from the Dollar Tree also. I just bought a stack of maybe 3 or 4, and I have things pre-written for the lessons on these whiteboards. And then I usually have one blank, so that way I can easily grab it and start writing on it. This is another example of a Dollar Tree whiteboard. I always start the class with them using complete sentences if they are able to. If they're not able to speak complete sentences, then I just simply ask their name, but you want to try to encourage a complete sentence. So I told you that I love the Dollar Tree. I actually found these random shapes, circles, squares, different things that I found in the school section, and I just wrote my name on it because if you can go like this and you can trace underneath and show them a complete sentence. Another favorite of mine that I got from the Dollar Tree are these particular props. I use these for my upper level classes. Sometimes there's push and pull or hot and cold. These are amazing. I also got these alphabet cards, which they have a lot of animals on them. So I use this a lot in the classroom just to show them some kind of animal so I don't have to get a stuffed animal of every single kind of animal. This just has so many different kinds that you can use. If you just hold up a card and say bird, and then you obviously can use TPR, but it really helps them understand it. I would say that my most used props are cat and dog. So at the very least, if you don't have a lot of props lying around, I would suggest getting at least a cat and dog stuffed animal or cards or something like that, just because you can do all kinds of things with cat and dog. You can talk about their ears, you can talk about their tail, how many legs they have. So these are my go-to props and I always make sure I have them out on my table when I'm about to teach. Another prop that I like to use a lot, this is a reward system that I found on Amazon. I'll link it in the description box so that way you can find it easily, but it's ice cream. Literally every kid loves ice cream. So I use this as a reward a lot. You can use them for counting. You can use them for colors. So something that I do in my classes is I have the students eat the ice cream at the end. It's something that's unique. It makes them laugh and it's super fun. I'll do something like this. Open up. And they love it. So that's just something that I do in my classroom that my kids just think are hilarious. And you want to do something like that so they have fun and they enjoy learning English and they want to come back to you. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. Please like and subscribe to my channel and I will have tons more videos about tips and tricks on how to teach online, not just for VIPKid, but I also work for other companies as well. And this channel is all about how to make money online. Thank you. I'll see you in the next video.